All right, welcome back to episode 5. Nothing is written is going to be our last bit of Battlefield 1. And if I remember correctly from playing this game when it first came out, I don't remember the rest of the campaign, but I think I remember this. And it's the horse mission, and you have to, like, blow up an armored train. That's what I think happens, but I could be wrong. If I'm wrong, great. If I'm not, then this is the only thing I remember from playing it the first time. And if this is the horseback mission, I despise it. I hate the horses in this game. Or Battlefield 5, whichever game it is. Which, obviously, we had a horse last episode, so I'm pretty damn sure it's this one. Like, you start this mission riding in a pack of horses.
The Arabian Desert. A vast ocean of drifting sands and scorched, sun-baked rocks. Beneath these endless dunes, oil, the lifeblood of our new mechanical century. For more than 400 years, the Ottoman Empire has ruled these lands, controlling all that's to be found here. But the Ottomans do not rule unopposed. Small bands of Bedouin rebels have united to overthrow the Empire. They strike without warning and then vanish into the desert. Fighting alongside them is a lone British officer whose exploits have earned him wide renown. The world has taken to calling this man Lawrence of Arabia. In the desert, you rely on good planning.
Ooh.
But you also hope for a dash of luck. And luck was with us when we learned of a recently derailed Ottoman train carrying a most interesting piece of cargo.
I don't remember this at all.
A small patrol had joined the Ottomans who survived the crash. Together, they guarded the wreckage and waited for reinforcements. A lone fighter has just one advantage over a large enemy force. A lone fighter can move unseen. The tribesmen fought unconventionally, using weapons they knew well. Endurance, individual intelligence, courage were their primary assets. When your enemy has better weapons and better equipment than you, steal from your enemy.
Hmm?
There's a world of difference between seeing something and having it in your own two hands.
Şimdi çıkarsan canını çok yakmayacağım. Kendine bir faydan olsun. Teslim olursan yaşarsın.
This is exactly what I wanted. Oh, and we have extra ammo. Oh, that is just beautiful.
You did not think we would be fast enough to catch you here, did you? Lawrence of Arabia. Actually, I was rather depending on it. Eh, Lawrence? Ah. Well, this is very clever. Now the hunter becomes the hunted. So who might you be? How enchanting you are, my dear.
Ahmed. I'll show you enchanting. If it weren't for you, I'd be free.
Free, is it? You'll be free when you're dead. And I'm happy to tell you, the Empire intends to grant you all this freedom very soon. Even now, an engine of destruction scours this desert, obliterating your allies. Your families, your homes. Soon there will be nowhere to run. Nowhere to hide.
Yeah, this is that train shit I remember.
So all that you know, and all that you love, will be ashes. You will all be free.
I'm pretty sure I'm playing the one that was released in 2016, not 18.
Send him off into the desert naked to die.
but think about it.
Right.
I'm sorry. My friend here, she can be a little brusque.
You're going to tell me how to lie to your train so we can lure it into a trap and destroy it.
Impossible. To even begin to talk to that train, you would need an entire book of communication codes.
Oh, like this one, you mean?
You can never stop the progress of machines! One day, the whole world will take your lands and the precious black gold beneath its sands!
We shall see, my friend. Of course, obtaining the codebook was not enough. To destroy this iron dragon, this Canavar, as the Ottomans had named it, we had to send it 3 encrypted messages telling it to stand down. There were Ottoman outposts scattered along the railroad tracks. The commanders there carried high-priority message capsules. We had to use those to send our orders. Infiltrating the village wouldn't be easy. A full detachment of Ottoman soldiers had occupied it. The Ottomans had chosen an isolated location for their desert outpost. It seemed lightly defended. It was also well stocked with arms and equipment. The ancient ruins were all that remained of a civilization now lost to time. The Ottoman Empire brought in the modern world with a host of armored vehicles and field guns. 3 commanders to eliminate, 3 personal message capsules to be stolen.
Oh, it sounds so ass.
Our false orders. How Zara tackled this dangerous and audacious mission was up to her. The Bedouin treasured their horses, and in return, those animals granted their riders unparalleled speed and mobility.
Should have scouted it out, but it's fine. What the fuck?
Of a clear shot. Look at this shit. I can't get a clear shot because he's marked. Unfucking real. Hear another one close. Flamethrower. I don't know if he can execute them or not. What? What the fuck? I don't think I can get to his satchel. Oh great, I gotta restart the mission. Fucking get to it, dude. We got blessed, didn't we? I think it actually picked it up, too. Holy shit. Wait, I have to go back and fucking...
Single order wouldn't be enough. Ottoman protocol required the message to be received in triplicate before the train would acknowledge it as German.
I don't remember this at all, so. Maybe it's like an online thing, like a game mode or something? This one should be fairly easy, no?
Yeah.
To be honest, I don't really see that many guys here. Don't miss.
We were putting a great deal of trust in Zara's capabilities, but I had complete confidence that she would carry the day.
I don't know where this commander guy is. I don't see the guy I just called out. There's a guy close right, so it's kind of like relevant. I mean, this is just... Why did he do that? I only see one way to do this.
Did all that for nothing?
Message you would have wanted. Lawrence was such a good host. It almost seemed rude to escape. I made sure to note the location of Lawrence's camp, of course. Which means the train knows too. Twice you told that train everything was clear, but I told it exactly where to attack. The beast has your scent, my dear. And it's coming to slaughter you and your little band of rebels. First, the firestorm from the cannon. Then, up close with the troops to slaughter any survivors. The legend of Lawrence of Arabia dies tonight.
Slipped away just in time. Tilkichi was a fool to think we'd ever stay after he escaped.
The carnival won't stop hunting us.
No, it won't. Let me think.
The train's coming a long way, so it'll have to stop to take on water. That's where we strike.
Agreed. I'll deal with any sentries, then rig explosives on the track.
Yes, and I'll rally our fighters.
When I blow the lines, the train will be trapped. So when you hear the blast, you need to attack them with everything you have.
It's good. But you know that there's a chance the men may not come. You may set off those explosives and find you're out there all alone. You know that.
I guess I won't know either way until I set it off.
Yes, no.
Man makes plans, and God laughs. As it turned out, the small town where we would ambush the train had a significant enemy presence. Those troops would have to be dealt with before the explosives could be set.
Ooh, this is a game changer. What is my objective? Destroy all the vehicles. Okay. Well. So we'll need dynamite, and I'll have to place it. Hmm.
I got dynamite in here? Is that my three is? No, I have the grenade gun. I wonder if we can line up a collat on these two without alerting these three. Is he gonna stand at the wall? Yeah.
Those troops in the village had to be dealt with before we could push on with our plan to destroy the train.
Oh. So how do we get this one away from these two? You can easily collate these two, but how do we... I mean, you got this guy here, too. Maybe we can take him... right here. Line up for me. Shit.
Those troops in the village had to be dealt with before we could push on with our plan to destroy the train.
Well, I know the armored dude isn't dead, so where is he? Alright. Let's let him rip. Clear the village. Unfortunately, I don't know where the jug is. Oh, there he is.
Once Zara secured the town, the trap could be set for the arriving train.
Fuck. Wait, what happened? When I'm dead? Wait, what? Wait, what am I? I actually don't exactly know what I'm supposed to do. Your bullets do anything? No. Need to be sure. So is that loud ass noise like when they're raining in fucking mortars or something? This gun fucking damn. What the fuck? Damn. The fuck? Damn. Where's it going? Heal, please. Thank you. Okay. Interesting rifle, that's for sure. Is that it?
Vengeance can be a sweet or bitter brew. How did you find it, Zara?
And you're right, we do need to think bigger, act bigger. Maybe even the Suez Canal. Tell me, what do you know about battleships?
Alright. That was the campaign here on Battlefield 1. Just kind of a war stories thing, as it says. You know, there wasn't anything crazy, but we do have this here. The Remember Us closing message. I guess we'll watch this. If there's any copyrighted music, it'll probably be edited out. It'll just mute everything, so we will see. But I guess we'll watch this. Or is this a mission? We're only at 49 minutes, so if it's a mission, we'll play it.
One day.
But I don't think it is.
All this will be over. The war to end all wars will be won. By one side or the other. The guns will rust. Grass will grow. And there'll be nothing left of any of this. The land will heal itself. As everything does in the end. We'll be long gone by then, but maybe not forgotten. History only remembers 1 in 1,000 of us. Then the future will be filled with stories of who we were and what we did, how we lived, how we fought, and how we died. When this is all over and the war is won, they will. But until that day comes, we will stand. We will look death in the eye. And we will fight.
All right, I think that was it. We'll go ahead and skip the credits. And I think that's all she wrote. I'll get out of that. Yeah, that's it. So if you enjoyed the little mini series here, little mini 6-episode thing, make sure you leave a like. And, of course, make sure you subscribe. I will be downloading Battlefield 5 if there's a campaign. If there's not, then I guess we won't play it. But I got Battlefield 5. We'll play it. We'll check it out. And, yeah, we'll go from there. But a little mini-series here. And got to play some War Stories, which was fun. So make sure to like, subscribe, sponsor the equipment description below. It's going to be it for me. Thanks for stopping by. I'm out.